YouGuys.com presents Paradise, Louisiana. Paradise, Louisiana is brought to you by Circle K, Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Demco, CCA Louisiana, and the CCA Louisiana Star Tournament, Relief Windows, Visit Baton Rouge, an authentic Louisiana experience, and by Farm Bureau Insurance.
Welcome to this week's edition of Paradise, Louisiana. I'm Gary Rosponi. Back at Superior Bait and Tackle, let me tell you what. If you want to do something good in the outdoors, the duck season is about to over. Deer season is winding down. We still got rabbit and quail, and we got squirrels. But let me tell you something right now. Fishing is hot everywhere we go. So you stay tuned. We're going to have a quick duck report today. Probably got some word from Larry Reynolds, and it's going to give you an idea of how it's been mixed. So just stay tuned. We're going to visit Chas again. I'm telling you what, he knows the trick down the Pontchartrain Basin. So you're watching Paradise, Louisiana. Superior Bait and Tackle on Seagan Lane.
My name is James Loop, and I won the 2020 Chevy 1500.
It was first day at roughly 5:30, 6 o'clock in the evening. I was like, let's stay fishing. And she's like, maybe we need to get back to the launch, you know? Yeah, I had a blast. It was a great summer tournament. Thank you, Super Chevy dealers, for my 2020 Silverado.
The best part about being a member of a Touchstone Energy Cooperative is that it's your Touchstone Energy Cooperative. That's the power of your co-op membership. Demco, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
I've been asking him to change the oil for months now, and he never did. So I finally just went to Benny's. They even washed my car for free. Uh-huh. And you know what? It was amazing. Yeah, I left Benny's and got home before Rob even knew I was gone.
Benny? Who the heck is Benny?
For generations, anglers from across the globe have put their trust in Abu Garcia. Because out here on the water, we know our science is your religion. Fish like a fanatic with the latest generation of Revo. Featuring up to 24 pounds of max drag. Designed for leverage and power. Built on corrosion resistance and comfort. World-class adventure awaits with Revo. Abu Garcia for life.
On last episode of Dockside TV, you saw us start off the day catching big redfish under the birds, chasing white shrimp in Lake Pontchartrain. As the redfish bite slowed, it was picked up by big speckled trout eating matrix shad green hornet, and we had a fantastic day catching beautiful trout and beautiful redfish.
On this episode of Dockside TV that you're about to see, it was simply a continuation of that trip. We simply got up on the shoreline, but we switched to a matrix minnow, suspended jerkbait, and caught big speckled trout in 4 to 8 foot of water, working the jerkbait, and crystal clear green like Pontchartrain water. Enjoy this episode of Dockside TV.
All right, guys, we're going to go ahead and tie on the Matrix Minnow. See if we could yield a couple big fish on this. This is a perfect setup for fishing suspended jerk baits. And we're going to go ahead and see what we can do with this thing right here. And that's what we can do. That's what we can do. Twitch, 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 pause. Bam! Big trout. I think it's a trout. Should be a trout. It's a good one too, boy. Ooh, I like when they peel that drag, baby. I like when they peel that drag. Here she comes, coming in hot. Yeah, whammy. Big trouts. Big trouts on the lookout. I can't stress how much I love hard bait fishing for big trout. Look how he choked that thing down. Make sure you bring your pliers when you're using hard baits and make sure you're very careful. Don't want to catch a hook in the hand like my wife did over the summer. Those trebles on these Matrix Minnows are super sharp. Alright, we switched it up on them a little bit here. When these big trout are suspended in this 4 to 8 foot of water, I like to go to our Matrix Minnow, our jerkbait. This is an awesome, awesome bait for catching trophy-sized trout. And that's what these fish are. They're suspended right now, trying to attack those big, these big trout are trying to attack those shrimp, and they're suspended in like 6 to 7 foot of water. So this hovers down at about 3 to 5 feet, and it's an awesome bait. It's got good rattles in it. Great bait for big trout in the wintertime. Woo-hoo! Look at that bass. Holy mackerel. What I'm noticing here is the closer I get to the bank, the more bass and redfish we're catching. Again, need to watch my fingers here. I switched to this Matrix Minnow suspended bait because I'm trying to get me a trophy here. And I love hard baits for trophy trout. That's a trophy bass to say the least. Go ahead and let this guy go. All right, we're gonna go ahead and let this big bass go. I mean, what an incredible day today's been. Going from big, giant, beautiful reds to big, giant, beautiful trout. And now even just trophy-sized bass for, you know, the marsh estuary. It's an incredible day. I'm going to keep chunking this Matrix Minnow. See if I can get a big one. Let me show you the cadence with this Matrix Minnow and how I recommend using it to target trophy trout when you're fishing at 2 to 8 foot of water. Watch this here. So the wind, you typically want to throw this with the wind to your back. The wind's blowing from this direction here. So you want to keep that wind to your back and bomb it out there as far as you can. This is a finesse lure for big trout. So I would recommend like a 10 to 12 pound fluorocarbon. That's, I'm using some type of, there he is right there. We're making a fluoro right now. I haven't decided what size we're going to make yet, probably around a 12 or 14. And this is our prototype fluorocarbon right here. And it works great. And when this comes out, we'll be putting this in the monthly bait boxes. But, I mean, look at that, guys. Close to the bank, a big 2.5, 3 pound bass. Throw to the throw out to the depths. A beautiful...
Pod's moving in storage.
I need to clean out my study.
We'll deliver a container.
My brother-in-law's moving in.
Maybe he'll help you pack.
He's lazy.
We can refer some professionals.
It's just until he finds work.
We can keep things at our storage center for as long as it takes.
I am not happy about this.
Or you can keep your things on site for quick unloading.
Did you say freeloading?
I said unloading.
I heard freeloading.
I'm sure you did.
Store on site or let us drive your things to our secure storage center. Pods, moving and storage solved.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana. Look, everybody know if you've seen the paper, the Morning Advocate, if you've been listening, if you checked the last flight report from the Wildlife and Fisheries, Larry Reynolds sent it to us and a lot of other the venues. You can find it on their website. But just in general, you know, the duck report from Larry said that they had a 1.97 the ducks. It was 11% less than the December. In December, it was less at 2.21 million, below the long-term average. So they were down, and the numbers were down. You didn't have to tell us the numbers were down. The Southwest was so bad right now because of all the loss of the marsh. It had some areas. Ryan Lambert had a bad last few weeks. But what sustained them is that all the work they're doing down there, growing duck potatoes, there's a tuber is down there, the ducks love and eat. But the last week, so then there was no water at all. Okay, so if there ain't no water, they couldn't get it. He said there were thousands of ducks, they were rafting out in the Gulf. So and that's all their reports. But Ryan was really satisfied. He had a real good season. Best the first second plate killed more widgeon than they ever did. I talked to Mike Benz, and we had an opening. We had a good weekend with Mike Benz. Killed a lot of teal, a lot of gray ducks, and a few mottled ducks. But this last weekend, Saturday was a little slow. But he's been hunting with his grandson. He's been real tickled about this. Colton, he killed his first ducks, and shooting his 410, he killed two in the air, and he took a picture. And here's a great picture with Mike Bender's grandson, Colton Mongrief. So what a congratulations, Colton. And if you ever hunt with your kids and your grandkids and your granddaughters, let me tell you what, it's nothing like seeing them kill that duck. They'll go out there and get their waders or whatever. You might have to carry them. Keep them from getting real cold, and you got a lifetime buddy. So that's important. That's what I did with my grandsons. And while we're talking about duck, my grandson and his daddy, they're in Oklahoma right now. They didn't do good here. They're in Oklahoma. First day, they had mallards everywhere in the cornfields, and they couldn't get them to work in. Duke Landry. Duke is, y'all know Duke's wrestling. He's an outdoorsman supreme. I'm going to tell you what, I don't care what it is. I always pick on him. You know, he's a former world champion, oyster shucker. But Duke is a workaholic, but I'm going to tell you what. He's been going in Port Barry. He's been taking guests, taking people. Here's a group he took over there right now. This is Johnson. And then he took off to Oklahoma again for the second time, and he's killing mallards in Oklahoma. So congratulations. And some of these pictures, let me tell you, I got my grandson, Blake, and I got his daddy, Warren Ashford, and then one of their good buddies, Tyler Duvall. So in some of these pictures that I'm going to run on the screen. Now, let me go through these ducks. Let me see what else I'm missing. I didn't get the word from Top Gun. You know, he told me he was sending me. I guess they got last week. And the East Zone got one more week now, so next weekend. Plus, they got a youth hunt on the last day. They split their youth hunt. So, I was talking about, you know, how to get some information on wildlife and fisheries. You know, there's a bunch of magazines out right now, Marsh and Bayou, and And the Sportsman, everybody gets them. I get the Sportsman every month, and they got a lot of news there. But nothing's better than Joe Macaluso's column in the Advocate. Let me tell you what. If you want to get something on his calendar, it might not make the deadline, but go ahead and try anyway. You email your times, your events that are coming up this year, and a contact person, you put it all on there, and you email it to jmacaluso@theadvocate.com. And I'm going to tell you what, that calendar is updated every week. It's there. It gives you your club or your banquet or whatever you're doing to get it in there. So if I did wrong, Joe's going to fuss at me, but believe me, all my life, Joe Macaluso in the Morning Advocate has been the number one source for information. Now I'm going to go back, and duck season, like I told you, is there. We got a bunch of good seasons coming up. We're going to end at the end of the month with your woodcock, and like you said, we got one weekend left, or 1 day left for the youth hunt. But just check your calendar. Go back and check your booklet and see. Don't forget, now next year they're going to be changing. We'll be down at to three spits and just two zones. So back in old, there won't be no coastal, won't be no east, west, and what all the other ones. So remember that. You find keep in touch. Let me say this, too. I got some other reports right now, and I got some other pictures. Deer season's been very good. People right now, the kids, they were talking about the rut and how good it's been. And the deer are moving. I got some people who were killing. Stephen St. Cyr killed his second cull buck. They go to wildlife and management areas, they're doing it, or some of these clubs, they're taking these young people or the people that are physically challenged, and they're letting them kill these big bucks, but they're cull bucks. So Thistleweight, wildlife manager, Stephen and them killed his second cull deer over there this year. You can see the Malfoy horns on this picture. My grandson, great-grandson, Carson, killed his second doe of the year. He was hunting with his uncle, Micah Rasponi, and here he killed his doe, second doe. Nikki Gaspart, here's a beautiful deer she killed. It's 11-point, 19-inch spread, 190 pounds in the Union Hunting Club in Bienville. He was hunting with my... We would call it Louisiana Hunter, Paul Petit. Now, we're getting ready to go to fish, but I one other thing I wanted to tell you about this hunting and these seasons. You know, always weigh in. If they send out a survey, please weigh in. Larry Reynolds is the best I've ever seen. He'll take any information and any call you want to give him. You get in touch with the wildlife and fisheries, and all of them are like that. The people with the deer, if you got something wrong with your deer, you don't like the way your herd is, or you seeing something wrong, or you got a hog problem. I don't care when everybody got a hog problem right now. So kill every hog you can get to, do everything legally, and be safe. So, and when we come back, I'm going to have a Berkeley Abu Garcia fishing report.
Okay, Brett, safety and car insurance.
Never scored a safety. That's defense. But go on, please.
Yeah, defensive. That's exactly how you should drive.
There is no such thing as a defensive drive. Offense makes the drive.
Oh, I mean when you're on the road.
But it doesn't matter, home or away.
Okay, clearly I'm striking out here.
That's baseball.
Get great auto rates from Farm Bureau Insurance. Call your agent today.
Berkeley Powerbait Max Set. Outfishes original Powerbait by 45%, disperses a supercharged scent field that attracts more fish and triggers more strikes. Powerbait Max Set. Fish bite and won't let go.
Oh,
asking him to change the oil for months now, and he never did. So I finally just went to Benny's. They even washed my car for free. Uh-huh. And you know what? It was amazing. Yeah, I left Benny's and got home before Rob even knew I was gone.
Benny? Who the heck is Benny?
Welcome back to the Berkeley Abu Garcia Fishing Report. Before I get started to the fishing report, we had another good report come in from the Junior Southwest Bassmasters. They had their January tournament out of Bob Black, Bob Marine, and Bob Black. 15 to 18 years old, first place. You're listening to these weights. Brian Bryce, DiStefano or DiStefano, they say in Independence, but Bryce and him had 13.53 pounds. Second place was Bo Landry with 9.21, and third was Trent LeBeau at 8.74. Big bass was Bryce DiStefano, 4.56. And 11 to 14-year-old, first was Caleb Sellers with, yes, Caden Sellers, excuse me, at 12.26. That's a good stringer, folks. I'm going to tell you, the five fish. Second was Samuel Cobb Jr. at 9.72. Third was Luke Clark, and big bass was Caden Sellers. 7 to 10-year-old, first was Branson McMillan at 7.94. And first was, and then second was Gentry Rogers at 7.27. They were all close. And third was Lance LeRae. Big bass was Brayson McMillan. I kind of read my own writing sometimes. Adult, Samuel Cobb at 14 pounds. That's almost 3-pound average. And second was Will Majors, 14.42. Big bass, let's see, Brent Sellers come in third. All of them had 14 pounds, big one. A big bass was Samuel Cobb at 4.39. Now, we're starting off with a fishing report. I'm going to tell you right now, Island Marina, it is just gone crazy. All the captains over there, I'm talking about Clint DeArmas. Clint was so busy, he didn't send me a picture. He loves when I put pictures over there. He fills that table up with bass and redfish. The other guys are just catching specks. Now, and him and Gallo and all of them are catching specks. I want to remind y'all, other guys at other marinas all over the coast, all you do is you email me by Sunday night, send me a picture with names, with people in the picture, a good picture, if it's good, and Chris approve it, I'll run it on TV. Gary@ParadiseLouisiana.com. Email it by Sunday night, and I'll run it with the fishing report the weekend. I ask everybody, and I hope y'all do it. I hope some people would help me right now, because we... All these shows right now, we're doing our best, trying to keep sponsors, keep on the air. So if you would email me, tell me what you like more, you want to see more of or less of, whatever. So to keep you interested, and go see our sponsors. Go talk to somebody. You see our sponsors that we're running right now, thank them. Go there and spend some money with them. Come here at Island, right here at Superior Bait and Tackle and do it. So. Now, I'm going back to the fishing report. Mike Bentley is another one, the fishing fool. Perry Baez, good friend of mine, Carrot, he does sometime. He got his own little TV show. He's getting all his boats back. He's been catching bass off his dock. He's also been going in his boat while he's rigging and right down catching these beautiful bass. These bass are getting bigger. So he sent me that picture. So. And here's a picture that came in, William White. He got a big drum out of Big Lake. He caught it on a matrix shad, on a black and chartreuse matrix shad. It's a big drum, you see it. You know, drum them big are not quite as good to eat, but drum right now is one of the best foods you can get. You can take a drum, you can fillet it, you can boil the meat we put them in a cheesecloth, put crab ball, and you get them out and they get flaky, I seen KD put them in a skillet and just whiten them, and then make crab meat au gratin out of it. But it's all kind of ways you can cook a drum. I'm gonna see a fishing report too. Also, I've been getting it from Amelia again. My good friend over at Giant over there, he sent a picture the other day. I might have run it already, but Pat Terrio and him were fishing. They're fishing at this one. But John's been making these reefs, and he put them in 25-foot of water over there around Bob Buff, and then off of Amelia. He's finding these drop-offs. Let me see if I got anything else. Other fishing reports I'm getting. Sakale, still unbelievable, Toledo Bend. We're having a lot of wind right now. I talked to Chris Macaloosa. Them boys, they catch them off the intercoastal. Every time you find fresh water or they're coming out and canals are running out in the intercoastal, they're catching them in the rock dams. So if you don't know where to go, you go to Lake Catherine and you just go follow the drains. You can fish drop shot. But right now, the bass are biting. The best bait, live shrimp under a cork. Go by Island Marina, talk to anybody there. They free good with the information, and they're willing to help everybody. So stay tuned. Be safe. I'm not even going to mention it, but had three more funerals last week. One of them was really, really close to me. Gary Graves lost his daddy. When I tell you about a politician that does his job and knows what he knows from the time he was working with Coastal Restoration to what he does now and what he does with Redfish. That was a great loss. Great loss. His dad, John, his name was all over Billings as an architect and engineer. Church was full. Garrett, remember, condolences to you, your mama, and everybody in your family. You are super. Paradise, Louisiana is one of your biggest fans. See y'all next week. You're watching Paradise, Louisiana.
BBQGuys.com presents Paradise, Louisiana. Paradise, Louisiana is brought to you by Circle K, Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Louisiana Fish Fry Products, Demco, CCA Louisiana, and the CCA Louisiana Star Tournament, and by Farm Bureau Insurance.